impress her. Well, I tried to press upon them that this wasn't the case. We often got into heated debates throughout about the next year and a half. One night, laying in bed, heartbroken because the debate had gone awry. A few things were said that should not have been said. But it looked as if I was getting desperate. Then all of a sudden, I heard this voice coming. And that voice said to me, "Young man, you are in deep trouble. And you need to do something. Now, what are you going to do?" You only have two choices. Choice number one, you can follow the status quo. Do nothing. Continue to beg, plead. Maybe at some point you'll get them to act. And you might be able to save your eyes. Otherwise, you are destined to be blind at an early, early age. Or you can take number two. You can take matters in your own hands. You could get up. You can take the matters in your own hand to solve your problem, because you've got a problem. And you had better act now. Fortunately for me, I did take the second approach. Started by realizing, you know what? You have a problem. A real problem. That problem is very dire. You'd better do something. So I developed a plan. A plan that would take me out of school for 3-4 weeks. Worked picking oranges and making the money to get my glasses. Possibly would save my eyesight. I first took this proposal to my principal in high school, who I had become very close with. But he intervened at first and said, "Wait a minute, let us go talk to your parents and see if we can get any movement." I said, "Okay, that's fine. Except one thing, you had better get results. If you don't get results to my satisfaction, I will be out of here on Monday morning working to solve this problem. I will not allow myself to go blind without doing something on my own." So that evening after school, he and my homeroom teacher did drive me home. They talked to my mother for about an hour. They stressed upon her that the situation was a heck of a lot worse than they could imagine. At that point, I started to see some sign of change in her attitude. She took it very seriously. Then she told them that she would talk to my father when he got home from work. Well, later that evening, he got home. She talked to him. We had another conversation that went the other way. He got upset because I had brought in my teacher and my principal. He felt that I'd gone overboard. And then he tells me, "We don't know whether you really need glasses or not. We will deal with this in our own way." Well, at that point, I lost it. I lost it and kind of went off with some savory language that I later apologized for. But that's when I dropped the bombshell and I said to them, as of Monday morning, I will be out of state. Period. I don't care what you say over your objections. I will be out of school because I will not allow myself to go home. Well, that broke them down. My mother later came in, begged me, pleaded me not to drop out of school, that they would take care of what they had to do. To her credit, they did. 3 weeks. Within the 3 weeks, and a blasting from my doctor, I had my glasses and the opening of a new world. One of the things that I used to like to do when I first got my glasses, things were so different. I would take them off, then put them back on, see the wide world of difference. I thought about this for quite a while. I started to wonder, I had negative thoughts about our parents, what they had done. And I asked myself over and over, did they do this purposely, or was it just a mishap? Well, I came to the conclusion, I didn't despise my parents or anything because I loved them. But after thinking about it for a long time, I realized that they had given me something, that even though what they did had a negative and cognitive effect, I realized that they had done, had given me something that would carry me for the rest of my life. They had given me a whole new insight of life. Self-dependent is what it was. Being able to look at life from a different perspective. Learning how to set priorities. And learning self-reliance and independence. And that's when I made a commitment to myself that I would never allow my life to be dictated by someone else. That whatever I needed or thought that I wanted, I would get it. With or without their support. I reminded them of this time and time again. I told them that their only responsibility at that point was the other four kids in our family. Because I was never depend on anyone. That they had given me that greatest gift